Welcome, it's Facts You Don't Know. If it's your first time here and you want to find out new facts that will definitely make you smarter and more, well, and first make sure to subscribe and activate the notification bell so you don't miss anything.
Katrina Darlis lived with her father and mother in a modest house in which they raised their children. They were a poor family, but they were a loving and understanding one. What they lacked in material possessions, they more than made up for in compassion and generosity. These were the rules by which the Darlis family lived. Their father was a carpenter who frequently produced carpets for nearly every hotel, which he then delivered to the establishment. The mother was a dedicated homemaker who raised her children. They were a family of three until Katrina purchased a little canary bird for the family, and they formed a family of four as a result of her parents' fondness for making fun of her. The canary was adorable, and it sang brilliantly. It woke Katrina and her parents up in the morning with joyful chirping, and they were in a good mood to begin their day. Michi is the name she gave to the canary, which she described as a cute name for a sweet birdie. Michi was very much loved and cared for by Katrina, who was devoted to him. It was as if it were her child. Hilda, Katrina's mother, became ill, her health deteriorated, and she sought treatment from a number of doctors. She required several prescriptions and hospitalizations, which were too expensive for her family's limited financial resources. The father put in more hours, but it didn't make much of a difference. As a result, Katrina felt it was her turn to lend a hand. She was aware that the hotel for which her father had produced carpets was in need of fresh maids. The hotel was in the process of hiring maids and cooks. A chef's income was significantly greater than Katrina's, therefore she wished she knew how to prepare food. She informed her father that she plans to seek for and obtain employment in order to assist him and her mother. The father wasn't quite on board with the plan. He was concerned that Katrina was still young and that working as a maid would be exhausting for her. Nonetheless, she was adamant, and they desperately needed the money. As a result, the father was forced to agree. Within a week of submitting her application, Katrina was hired as a maid at the hotel where she was staying. Ample space and luxury were provided by the hotel. It was the most breathtaking spot she'd ever seen in her life. With the exception of one family, Betty, the rest of the staff members were beautiful and got along well with Katrina. Katrina didn't bother her since she felt she was very social. However, despite the fact that her co-workers were kind individuals, the man for whom they worked was not. The hotel's general manager was an extremely harsh and unequal individual. He was solely concerned with money and the prospect of making even more money. He didn't give a damn whether one of his staff was unwell or otherwise unable to do their duties. He was despised by everyone. Katrina found the work to be difficult, if not downright unpleasant. In addition, she was responsible for sweeping and wiping the floors and cleaning the stairwells, as well as hanging and ironing them when they were washed. It was the first time she'd ever done so much labor in her life, and she was really thankful to her mother for taking care of all the household tasks and cooking for the family. She would return home exhausted, but she was grateful for the opportunity to assist. When things became difficult, she reminded herself of the salary she would receive at the end of the month, which gave her the motivation to persevere. In addition, her co-workers were really kind and enjoyable to be around. When Katrina earned her first paycheck, she set aside a tiny portion of it for herself and gave the rest to her father, who used it to purchase medicine and adequate nutrition for her mother. Her mother was improving, and she was confident that she would be okay shortly. Katrina was cleaning one day when she heard a weird noise. She investigated. She wasn't sure at first since it was muffled, but as she focused, she saw it was still there. She followed the sound and was pleasantly surprised when she discovered where it came from. It belonged to a dog, of course. The puppy was tiny and squeaky and curled up on itself to keep warm. It was white with a few gray splotches around its neck, which Katrina noticed when she held it in her hands. Oscar was the name of the dog on a tag that was attached to its neck. So he must have owners, and they must be within walking distance of the hotel. Depending on the age and size of the puppy, he was just a few weeks old when he was born, give or take a few weeks. Katrina determined that she would look after it until she could track down its owners. She fed it milk and wrapped it in an old scarf to keep it warm. She concealed it in the staff room and instructed her buddy to take care of him while she was on her shift at the time. Her companion enthusiastically agreed. When Katrina had done her rounds, she went to the staff room to change into her work clothes. She was startled by loud noises. "Come have a look. You'll be surprised at how adorable it is," Katrina's buddy shared her thoughts. Take a look at the white patch on the bridge of its nose. What a sweetheart! The other maid burst out laughing. Let me have a look, another person offered. No, I'm the one who has to hold it. Wait for yours, please. Katrina exhaled a sigh of relief, but she was also a little shocked. Guys, I'm pleased you adore Oscar, but you're being a little too vocal about it. It's imperative that you lower your voice or else Mr. Jackson will come and take it away, Katrina issued a warning. Or toss it away, you mean, her buddy said, and they all burst out laughing at her mistake. They decided to take turns caring for the puppy until they were able to determine who it belonged to. Katrina walked through the store asking people whether they'd seen a dog or if they'd lost one, and they all said yes. So yet, no one has said yes. However, the company was enormous and its customers were numerous. She only had to be patient for a while. Oscar reminded her of her canary, Michi, which she had since long forgotten. Her father speculated that the animal could be unwell because it wasn't eating as much as it had been. Katrina made an effort not to be very concerned about it. Michi was going to be okay, I felt confident. Betty showed up one day when Katrina and her pals were enjoying themselves with Oscar. Can you tell me where that dog came from? She inquired. In response, one of the maids said, Please don't tell anyone. We're attempting to track out its owner. This is something you're doing in order to keep it hidden from the management. Who was it that brought it in the first place? Betty inquired, her voice rising in pitch. That's what I did, in response, Katrina stated. I discovered it. And you didn't tell Mr. Jackson, did you? I take it you didn't tell Mr. Jackson. Betty drew an irises from her brow. No, I didn't, Katrina responded emphatically. Mr. Jackson was ready and waiting for Katrina the following day. As he glared her down, he appeared to be in a state of rage. Katrina Darlis, get your belongings together. You've been fired, Mr. Jackson shared his thoughts. Betty informed me that you were maintaining a dog, which was in violation of the company's norms and regulations. Employees are not permitted to own animals, Mr. Jackson was the one who responded. But sir, I'm simply keeping it until I can track down its rightful owners. The tag indicates that they must be someplace in the hotel, or else they'll return for him, Katrina responded in kind. They will not locate you or the dog if they return, which is unfortunate because they're likely to do so. There will be no departure, Mr. Jackson yelled angrily. Katrina said her goodbyes to her pals and then she was gone. Even though she was distraught, her actions were justified since she was just attempting to assist, and she still required the work. Her mother was improving, but she was not yet completely recovered. When Katrina returned home, her parents greeted her and the dog with open arms. When she expressed gratitude for their assistance, they assured her that she would soon find another employment opportunity. Michi seems to be a favorite of Oscar's. In order to prevent this, Katrina let Michi out of his cage, and he promptly climbed on top of Oscar's head. It was really funny. The next day, Katrina set out to seek for work. She brought Oscar along with her, snapped a photo of him, and distributed it around town in hopes that someone would see the advertising and identify him, despite the fact that she'd grown to like the dog. Someone came to her door after about a month and a half of waiting. When she answered the door, she was greeted by a wealthy woman dressed in a stylish maxi dress with a fur coat draped over her shoulders. She had the appearance of someone who belonged on the cover of a fashion magazine. A man in a really good suit was standing alongside her, and a young child was accompanying them. Katrina was under the impression that they were a family. "Excuse me, but is this Katrina's house?" says the narrator. The gentleman inquired. "Yes, that's correct. What can I do to assist you?" she inquired. "Is it correct that we were informed you might have discovered a dog?" says the narrator. "Please, come in, thank you. Sorry for being so disrespectful and keeping you waiting at the entrance. If you want to come, I have your dog." Katrina was the one who responded. After she had welcomed them into the house and offered them tea and cookies, she proceeded to ask some questions. "Please pardon me, but I need to ask you a couple of questions just to be sure. What's your dog's name, and what distinguishing characters does he have?" Katrina was the one who inquired. "A white blotch on his nose and gray splotches around his neck," the youngster said in one breath. "Oscar, his tag, has his name etched on it, and it's gold with a blue ribbon." "Oscar had a white splotch on his nose and gray splotches around his neck," the boy explained in one breath. "It's fine that you're a dog." Quickly, after calling Oscar over, the youngster recognized him and he immediately went towards him. "We've heard that you took care of our dog and were dismissed from your work as a result of it. We sincerely apologize for this. You know, my husband is a surgeon and he had an emergency, so we needed to get back in the car and get out as quickly as possible. I'm not sure how we managed to forget about Oscar in our rush to depart. The only problem was that we were already on a plane and couldn't do anything. We attempted to contact the hotel, but were told that the management had stated that there was no puppy in the area. We returned to the hotel as soon as we could and were informed of what occurred, the wife said. We were deeply sorry for what occurred to you. You were fired from your position. My husband and I would like to make amends and reward you for your nice deed, so please accept our gift. Please, don't bother, there's no need. I was only carrying out my responsibilities, Katrina said in kind. However, we appreciate what you did and would want to assist you in the same way that you've assisted us, the husband added. I'm a doctor and I've heard your mother was unwell. Her treatment would be entirely on my shoulders. It's my spouse who said it, the wife claimed. And I'd like if you could work for me and assist me in my fashion business. I'm looking for someone sweet and honest like you, Katrina. The wife made the proposition. Katrina couldn't believe what she was hearing. She expressed her gratitude to the entire family. The husband went to the house and checked the mother before telling Katrina that he would visit the following day to take them to his clinic. Katrina was astounded by how a small act of genuine kindness can have such a profound impact on someone's life. She expressed her gratitude profusely. Thanks for watching. Please like and share the video in social networks. We'll be right back to you as fast as we can.